Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. Today I'm going to be walking you through my day and showing you some of my tips and tricks and things that I try to do every day to maintain a healthy lifestyle. So this is not all encompassing. I don't do everything perfectly, but I want to show you just a few quick little changes or habit changes that you can make that will hopefully help you to be a little bit healthier every day. I want these things to be just realistic, doable things that don't feel unattainable, but they're things that you can easily add into your daily routine. So let's get into it. Now, before we get any further into this video, I wanted to stop and say thank you to you guys for 500 subscribers on this channel. It seriously means the world to me. And for that, I'm gonna be doing a giveaway. Now, if you've been on my channel for any amount of time, you probably already know the number one product that I rave about more than anything is the Chom Chom Roller. This thing is absolutely incredible. It's basically a reusable lint roller. So if you have pets, or if you just have lint and human hair around your house once in a while, this thing is amazing at picking up all of that stuff, and it's reusable, so you never have to buy a lint roller ever again. So I'm gonna be giving away, not this one, this one's mine, I'm not gonna give you a used one, but I'm gonna give you a brand new Chom Chom Roller to the winner of this giveaway. I will include all the details and how to enter the giveaway at the end of this video, so make sure you stick around till the end. So let's get into these healthy habits, starting with my morning routine. I am such a big believer in starting yourself off on the right foot in the mornings. I think it's so important in just setting the tone for the rest of your day. So the first thing I do in the morning is I fill up my big cup of water, and I try to make myself drink the entire thing first thing in the morning. I don't always feel like drinking that much water in the morning, but I find that if I do, I kind of tend to remember to drink more water throughout the whole day. Whereas if I don't drink water first thing in the morning, I kind of just forget about it and I don't end up drinking enough water. So drink your water first thing in the morning, force it down if you need to, just to get yourself going, and it kind of helps remind you all day when you need some more water. My next tip is for you coffee drinkers. So if you're like me and you love a warm cup of coffee to wake you up in the morning, here's my tip. Do yourself a favor and invest in some high quality, fresh coffee. It makes all the difference. I find that if I have a good quality coffee, I don't need any add-ins. I don't need any creamer, any sugar, nothing like that. So you can save yourself a lot of kind of empty calories, a lot of sugar that your body doesn't really need, just by getting yourself a better quality coffee so you don't need all those add-ins. I recommend going to your local coffee shop and seeing what they have on hand and trying out a few different kinds till you find kind of what your taste is or what you enjoy. Also, if you want a really good one to start with, go to ptscoffee.com. I'll link this in the description box. They have some really good coffee. They're a local coffee shop here in Kansas City where I live. They're one of my favorites. I would recommend their Flying Monkey Roast if you're looking for just like a good medium roast that's pretty unoffensive. Like, it doesn't have any super strong flavor notes in any one direction or another. It's just like a good basic coffee, and it's so delicious. So I will link that in the description box below if you want a good place to start. They will grind it however you like, depending on how you brew your coffee, and it's so, so good. But get yourself a good coffee and you'll find you don't even need cream or sugar. The last thing I encourage you to do in the mornings is get yourself off to a good start with a healthy breakfast. I try to incorporate some kind of fruit or vegetable into every single meal. This morning I had avocado toast, so I got a little avocado. Sometimes I'll top that with tomato, or I'll add a little side of fruit to go with it, anything like that. But try to incorporate some fruits or vegetables into every single meal, not only with your breakfast, but also with your lunches and dinners. Think about how you can add some extra vegetables in, maybe sneak them in by adding some cauliflower rice in with your normal rice, or adding some spiralized zucchini in with your pasta. Maybe sneak some mushrooms or beans in with your meat. Maybe replace your meat entirely with beans or mushrooms, something like that. And you can get so many more vegetables into your diet if you just start to try to think, how can I add more vegetables into every single thing that you make? The next thing I did today is I got my workout in. I think it is so important to put your workout on the schedule, treat it like a non-negotiable appointment, if you will. That way you have no excuse to not make it happen. What that workout looks like is totally up to you. I want it to be something that you enjoy. That way you can sustain it and continue doing it for a long period of time. Try different things if you want, whatever works for you. I have a whole video on how to maintain your workout motivation. I will link that up here in the cards, as well as in the description box below, so you guys can watch that when you're done watching this video if you are needing some tips and some help staying motivated and maintaining a workout schedule over a long period of time. That video is for you. Okay, you are officially caught up on my morning. It is now lunchtime, and for lunch, I typically eat some kind of leftovers. I am such a huge believer in cooking in bulk. So anytime you are making dinner, if you're gonna be having all of your pots and pans out and chopping up veggies and getting your kitchen dirty anyway, make extras every single time, and that can be meal prep for the next few days. If you're someone who doesn't like to eat the same thing over and over again, stick it in your freezer for a few days and then pull it out when you're ready to eat it again. But it is such a great way to keep food on hand without having to do those giant meal preps that I think are kind of overwhelming. And you also kind of get to have some more variety because you can cook something different every night and just cook in a couple extra servings, and then you kind of rotate out your different meal prep food, if you will. And so today I am having enchiladas. I made these last night. They are vegan enchiladas. If you want me to share the recipe, leave a comment down below. I can share that in a future video because they are bomb. But that is what I'm having for lunch. Super, super easy. And that's what I do pretty much every day. Highly recommend using this meal prep method. My next tip might sound a little strange at first, but I actually think it might be the most important tip that I share with you guys. And that is to decide to enjoy cooking. Now, before you say, Lauren, I'm just not one of those people that likes cooking, or I'm a terrible cook, I actually don't think it's that black and white. I think a lot of cooking is the mindset that you go into it with. In just about every aspect of life, you can either choose to see the parts that are annoying and a pain and a struggle, or you can choose to see the good side of things, the positive side of things. So I encourage you to really make an effort to try to enjoy the process of cooking. I know I find a lot of inspiration from learning about other cultures and their approach towards cooking and food. There's so many other places in the world that have the most beautiful traditions and cultures around their meals. And I find it so inspiring because these people are so passionate about the food that they create. I also love watching cooking shows and getting inspiration from stuff like that. I love watching YouTube videos of people cooking and creating new recipes, and I find a lot of inspiration from that, and it really helps me approach cooking with a positive mindset, and I actually get excited to make something new instead of thinking about, oh, this is such a pain. I don't like chopping up vegetables. I don't like having to clean my kitchen. All the things that my mind wants to go to, I try to just put that aside and actually enjoy the process. Speaking of enjoying the cooking process, my next tip for you is to ride the momentum when you're cooking. What I mean by that is when you find yourself in the groove when you're cooking and you're actually enjoying yourself, you're in the mood, you're motivated, ride that wave and maybe make some more food. Prep tomorrow's vegetables or chop up some extra fruit for the next day. Whatever you can do to kind of help yourself out for the future when maybe your future self doesn't feel like cooking or doesn't feel like waiting to have something prepared and you need something right away, do yourself a favor. And on those times when you are kind of enjoying yourself in the kitchen, do yourself a favor and get some extra stuff prepared. My final tip for you guys is to make a conscious effort to get your sleep. Sleep is so, so important to our health, and so many of us kind of put that on the back burner. And I know depending on what season of life you're in, that can be really, really difficult. So I understand it's not always easy, but do whatever you can to help yourself out to get some extra really good restful sleep. I find for me, it's really helpful to have a little bit of a wind down routine. I am a total night owl, and I find that in the evenings I get really motivated to get up and run around and do stuff. So I like to kind of have a little wind down routine for myself, which includes tidying up my house so that I have a clean house to wake up to in the morning, taking off my makeup, doing my skincare routine, brushing my teeth, all of that stuff. And it kind of just triggers my brain to know, okay, it is time to wind down. These are the things we do every day before bed. And it kind of just helps me relax and get a sense of calm. Again, for me, cleaning my house helps me feel relaxed and calm because then I have a tidy place to go to sleep in. All of those things are so, so helpful. So do yourself a favor and create some kind of a nightly routine that helps you kind of wind down and settle in for the night. And there you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed coming through the day with me, and I hope these little practical tips were helpful for you. If they were, click that like button down below. Now, I did not forget about our giveaway, so let me tell you all about it. Most of this is all good news, but I do have just a tiny bit of bad news, and that is that this giveaway is gonna be just for my US-based subscribers at this time. I'm so sorry if you are living in another country. I know I have subscribers from all over the world, which is amazing, and I really, really hope to include you guys in a giveaway sometime in the very near future. But for this one, we're gonna stick with the US. I am so sorry. Like I said, I will do an international giveaway sometime soon, so stay tuned. First things first, in order to be qualified for this giveaway, you need to be subscribed to my channel and click that like button and like this video. I know about 60% of you who watch my videos are not actually subscribed, so what are you doing? Hit that subscribe button, that way you can be qualified to win this Chomp Chomp Roller. Okay, now that we got the qualifications out of the way, in order to enter yourself into this giveaway, what I want you to do is comment down below your favorite healthy meal or snack. You can comment as many times as you want. Every single comment will be an entry into this giveaway. So if you comment 10 times, you get 10 entries into this giveaway. Also, for another bonus entry, head over to my Instagram and follow me there, and then leave your Instagram handle as a comment in this YouTube video. That way I can know that you're following me. If you already follow me, just leave your handle as a comment in this video and I will know that you're already following me. So that will count as an entry as well. And finally, the giveaway winner will be announced a week from today, Monday, September 28th. So make sure you get all your entries in before then, and I will announce the winner in that video, and then I will reach out to you from there. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks again so much for 500 subscribers. It seriously means the world to me. Make sure you're subscribed, enter yourself in this giveaway, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.